Jeux olympiques de la jeunesse 2016 à l'amphithéâtre d'Annard. Dans quelques minutes, nous commencerons le programme libre pour les dames.
God ettermiddag, mine damer og herrer. Velkommen til ungdoms-OL 2016 her i Hamar OL Amfi. Om noen få minutter skal dere få se kvinnenes friløp. Før vi starter konkurransen vil vi minne dere om at fotografering med blitz samt videoopptak forbudt. Vi ber dere også om å skru av lyden på mobiltelefonen, samt å la være å kaste ting ut på isen når løperne går sine programmer. Dersom dere har gaver og blomster som skal kastes på isen etter at løperne ferdig, må de være godt pakket inn før de kastes ut.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Youth Olympic Games 2016 here in Hamar Amfi Theater. In a few minutes, we will start the ladies free skating. Before we start the competition, we would like to remind you that flash photography and video recording is forbidden. We ask you to please turn off the sound on your mobile telephones and do not throw any items onto the ice during the competition. Gifts and flowers offered to the skaters at the end of their performance must be completely wrapped. Thank you for your attention.
The 1994 Olympic venue, the Hamar Olympic Amphitheatre, Lillehammer, is today's illustrious venue for the final drama from the ladies' figure skating event here at the 2016 Winter Youth Olympics. I'm Simon Golding, and I'll be with you for what promises to be 3 hours of world-class figure skating as 16 athletes through from the short program perform their longer program, the free program routines, in pursuit of gold here in Norway today. Well, Sunday's short program ended with 14-year-old Japanese skater Yuna Shirewa leading by just over a point from Kazakhstan's 16-year-old Elizabeth Tershimbaeva. Shirewa's score of 60.87 leaves her as marginal favourite heading into the free program. But there are some wonderfully talented junior skaters who have a real shot at the podium and maybe even gold if they can impress the people that we're seeing here. The judges being introduced to the crowd here in Lillehammer. In terms of those athletes that are within a couple of points from the Japanese leader, well, third placed Diana Nikitina of Russia. We've got Polina Tersikaya. And fourth and then joined fifth placed is Ji Hyun Byun of South Korea. And another Japanese skater, Kaori Sakamoto, alongside Byun. They're all in a strong position. And this generous and warm-hearted crowd here in Lillehammer will no doubt be willing home skater Junie Marie Benjaminson to a fitting final performance, although making the medals from 12th position after the short program is going to be tough for her, but she's going to get things underway in our free program skating. It is a beautifully poised competition, and it's all coming up live here on the IOC YouTube channel. So I talked about the fact that we do have world-class performances to look forward to today. A number of the skaters now featuring quite prominently on the ISU Junior Grand Prix. But also starting to make their way into senior competition. So even though still at relatively tender age, teenage years, there are some national champions competing today. They'll all have their personal goals in terms of where they finish, in terms of who we're looking at for the medals. Well, that'll be on page two of our start list. But as you can see, Benjaminson gets things underway for Norway. And then it's the Hungarian Medjesi. But as we move down through into those scores, the mid-50s onwards, so Anastasia Galyutsyan of Kazakhstan has an opportunity. I said Kazakhstan, my apologies, Armenia. She has an opportunity to get in amongst the medals through the higher scores into the 50s and the higher 50s, the names that I mentioned earlier, and with a real shout here today. It's going to be Japan's Yuna Shirewa who will look to hold everybody off, the only athlete to make it into the 60-point area on the short program. But don't forget, we have Polina Tereskaya of Russia, fourth at the moment, 58.65, but she's the current junior record holder for the combined score at world level. That's our first group then of skaters onto the ice to warm up. Benjamin Sinter head off, then Medyesi, Hagarova, Hock of Germany, and Li Jiangning of China. Those athletes scoring in the 40s and then down at just below 40 for the Slovakian Alexandra Hagarova. Opportunity now to check out the ice here in the arena that was built specifically for the figure skating at the 1994 games. So a venue steeped in history. Some athletes right there. Little line on one of those pages in the history books here today. Junie Marie Benjaminsen of Norway, 12th position after the short program, but had a marvellous achievement last year. First Norwegian lady to qualify for the free program in 16 years at the Junior World Championships, so plenty expected of her. And former Ukraine international coaching Alexander Smovkin will be looking for great things from his charge today. Prisina Medyesi of Hungary, 14th on 43.45. She'll go second in this group, followed by Alexandra Hagarova of Slovakia, who at the moment qualifying through in that bottom spot in 16th position. 38.75. Then it'll be Annika Hocke of Germany, 15th position for the Berlin athlete, coached by Manuela Macon. But a good result last year, finished second in the Riga Volvo Junior Open of 2015. So proved that she can deliver on the big stage. And then Li Jiangning of China has finished in bronze medal position twice in the senior Chinese Championships. 13th after the short program, 6.97. Jiangning. So plenty to look forward to in this opening group. And if you are new to figure skating, the long program lasting approximately 4 minutes in duration. The athletes will choose music to skate to, and they have to perform 11 elements within their program. That's a combination of jumps and spins, step sequences and linking sequences. That will become clear as this event moves on. The judges then take a look at that. Marks handed down from the technical judges. The performance will be marked. The referee will then bring in any deductions. And those deductions can happen for falls. Those deductions can happen for errors. There can also be technical deductions as well for things like costume infringements and for music duration. Athletes have to stick pretty close to the program duration that they've submitted. Right, we'll have this first group through, then we'll have the Zamboni out onto the ice to tidy things up. As you can imagine, with the kind of pressure that the international skaters put on the surface, there's a little bit of repair work in between the groups, in particular those toe jumps that take their toll on the ice texture. Company this afternoon. The athletes going through their final preparations ahead of their long programs, the free program. And the athletes plan in conjunction with coach and choreographer in order to deliver those 11 elements the judges will want to see, but those 11 elements are not required as they are in the short program. This is based on the skater and the coach and the choreographer's decisions. The technical judging panel will award a degree of difficulty based on the elements that we're going to see from each skater, and then they will be marked accordingly with additional bonus marks for very well performed jumps, but also if you do make errors, those marks can be negative as well. Quick reminder of what happened back in Innsbruck in 2012 in the girls' singles. Elizaveta Tukhomsheva of Russia taking the gold medal. Adelina Sotnikova of Russia as well on the podium with silver, and Li Jijun of China taking the bronze. For the boys' division, Yan Han of China took gold, Shoma Una of Japan with silver. Fedyosky Efremenko of Russia taking that bronze medal. And this is so often the case from the Youth Olympic Games competitions. The stars of today moving through to become the stars of tomorrow as they begin to compete at the highest level. So some warm applause from the Lillehammer fans behind their home athlete. No surprise to see the Norwegian flags waving here as Julie Marie Benjaminsen prepares to get her routine underway. So Benjaminsen in 12th position after the short program. Skated well, but after qualifying for the free program at the World Junior Championships last year, maybe would have had her sights set a little higher. And looking to build on that 47.18 score from the short program in this, her free program, which will be performed to the theme tune, the soundtrack from a film called The Milagro Beanfield War, if you remember that one, back in, I think, 1993, written by the composer David Grusin. Benjaminsen then, for Norway. Change of tempo brings the crowd on side. Jon-Marie Benjaminsen of Norway will be a little disappointed with some elements to that routine. She span really well. Good finish on that change of foot combination spin. But did have a few problems earlier on. Unfortunately fell on the triple flip. That was the first of the falls, but came back with a good spin on the layback. But then unfortunately for her, fell on the triple loop. That meant she couldn't get the double toe loop away, so that'll be more deductions for her. Maybe just a few nerves as part of that routine, performing in front of friends and family. And a slightly disappointed athlete skates away from the ice. Over to coach, former Ukraine international Alexander Shmovkin. She started so well, first Norwegian skater ever to land the triple toe loop combination. And she delivered that very nicely at the start of this routine. And the problems started, took a little extra step to get it away. But then the issue with the triple flip, as I said, came back nicely with that layback spin. That was strong part of her routine. The choreography was good as well. Good strong dance phases and nice step work. Unfortunately, just couldn't make the jumps down on the triple loop. No double toe loop. Managed to come back strong. Sarko. The fly into the sit spin. That little change of tempo, taking her into the axle combinations. Finally, the change foot combination spin at the end, and the crowd were right on side there. The ISU judging system very strict about how things are marked these days. So for over a decade now, the new judging system. So I'm afraid that there will be some deductions in there. And at last, a smile from Jon-Marie Benjaminsen of Norway. Here are the deductions. 2 marks taken off, leaving her on 69.98. As this event develops, we'll start to see how those marks reflect overall. So the second skater in our first group, Gina Medjesi of Hungary, 43.45 with her short program. We'll dance to a combination of soundtrack music from the film The Mission. Thank you. Drazina Medjeski of Hungary, 14th position after the short program. And rather like the Norwegian Benjaminsen, we'll certainly have some concerns after skating that free program. Just taking a little time to compose herself before her final presentation to the judges. A lot of pressure on these youngsters when it comes to the competition. What a fabulous opportunity to learn about competing at this level, at an event of this magnitude. Most have Grand Prix and national competition experience, but this Youth Olympic Games is something a little bit different, a little bit special. Sometimes it just takes a little while to settle in to competition at this level. So plenty for the judges to work with here on Megyes's routine. Did manage to get that first triple flip away, which was nice. And unfortunately for her, fell on the double axel, and that meant no double toe loop to follow. Not the only fall she had either. That's a shame, because those first two falls denied her the double, the combination. Came back with a layback spin. And down that triple loop as well. Fought hard for these. Eventually got that triple combination away. You've got to admire the endeavour there. Benjaminsen, some nice elements to that program, and the spins certainly save the day. Once again, we will see some deductions from Medjeski for the judges. Nervous wait for the marks alongside coach. Personal goals here, and trying to improve from that position at the moment of 14th. She's done well to qualify for the free program, and she'll take that. 74-16. The combined score, by the way, of Benjaminsen moving to 117-61. So Medjeski will just get past that. She'll squeeze by the skin of her teeth. 17-61. Bumps Benjaminsen down into second position for the moment.
Please welcome the next skater representing the Slovak Republic, Alexandra Hagarova.
Slovakia and Alexandra Hagarova next up. 16th. Just qualified for this free program after the short with a score of 38.75. May have seen Hagarova warming up earlier, just had a couple of spills in the warm-up, so let's hope she gets this together. Starts off with a track called Tell Me Something Good, finishes off with another Hang Up Today track, Ain't You Glad. Thank you. Well done to Alexandra Hagarova after a rather tense start. Recovered the situation nicely. Good modern arrangements there of a couple of classic tracks. Kept the tempo nice and high in that routine. That always keeps the crowd on side. Well, did well to recover nicely on a couple of those jump combinations. And some of you may have noticed some lyrics as well being heard in the songs. That's been allowed since 2014. Always used to be music without any lyrics at all, but that has all changed now. Again, an athlete that will be feeling there was a little bit left out on the ice there. Coach Bockart, I'm sure, will agree, but I thought this was a nice recovery after a tricky start. Fall on the triple flip. Fell on the first combination as well. She didn't get the double away, but she recovered nicely on the second combination. Little smile at the end of this one to show that she got that double toe loop away. Slightly tentative on some of the spins as well. That would have been tough by the judges. The step sequences were nice. Well, between the various elements, a little bit of character. Okay, just a little stuck in a couple of those jumps, but they definitely improved. Double axel and then went to the layback spin to finish. Consolation sometimes required from the coach. I think she's worried about the mark here. In 16th position at the end of that short program, I think she will struggle to make it out of that position, but she's qualified for the free. She's here and she's performed at this Youth Olympic Games. Always such a high pressure moment as you wait for those scores to come through. Athletes will have an idea of exactly what they were trying to achieve today. Safe to say, based on the reaction of our first three athletes, they've not quite been where they wanted to be. But here come the marks. 1:17.61 to beat. So 74.52. It's a solid score, the one mark deduction. Technical elements, solid presentation, just a little down at 34.37. Is that enough to get a past Benjaminson or Negyesi? The combined score. The answer is not quite, I'm afraid. 113.27. Next down onto the ice then from Germany. Just a little below par in the short program. 15th position with a mark of 41.52. Can the German athlete from Berlin improve the situation in her free program? Dancing to a fabulous track, Carmen, from the Georges Bizet. Back in 1895. Growing in confidence all the way through that routine. No wonder the smile is there. And Annika Hocker will have done her case no harm at all here at this Winter Youth Olympic Games with that free programme. Well, when you see that kind of performance, the routine just flies by. Comforted as well by that familiar piece of music. Always takes a little time to get to the parts of that composition that the crowd recognise. Once Toreador was ringing out, the crowd were on side. And Annika Hocker started to fly. An athlete that had her problems at the start. Little stumble on the opening triple, but really good recovery for the combination. Stumble, but nicely recovered through the combination, and then really from that point onwards started to grow in confidence. She did have the fall on the triple, so no double afterwards, but apart from that, the routine very strong indeed. Just got that feeling in terms of the way she was conducting herself on the ice. Character started to come through. She started to really perform to the crowd and the judges. And the spins and the step combination, very strong. That's super work. See it there, can't you? The confidence to really go after this routine. Step sequence to finish with a big smile. Now, what do the judges think? 117-6-1 leads for Fruzhina Migiesi and 83-6-8. That has a chance. Two very strong groups of marks through the technical elements and the presentation. Just that single deduction. 4. confirmation that Annika Arka does go into the lead. 125-20 her combined score. And that is what a strong lead as well. That should help her move, I think, from 15th position. We'll see how many positions she can rise as this afternoon moves on. Now, last of our opening group of skaters, 13th in the short program, Li Xiangning of China, 46.97, so has around about a 5.5 mark advantage over Annika Hock. She'll be dancing to My Fair Lady, a composition from 1956 by Frederick Lowe. Well, a wonderful flowing piece of music building to that triumphant finish, but not quite the triumphant finish that Li Xiangning, the 15-year-old from China, was looking for. A couple of rather innocuous errors during the course of that routine. One slightly frustrating tumble as well, just ahead of the fly change spin. Should have given herself a chance at the lead. 125-20 at the moment is the mark with Germany's Annika Hock. we'll have to wait and see after those errors. And obvious to see as well that that last spin did not quite finish on the final beat of the music. Part of the development for these athletes and for Lee, very comfortable in both junior and senior competition. Those two bronze medals at senior level, quite fantastic. Well, the jumping to start with was really strong. Great elevation on the triples. And then just that rather unfortunate tumble coming off the edge. Delayed her entry into the fly spin. Into those elements, then she really was very, very strong. Not quite as confident on the linking moves between the elements. So without doubt, excellent routine. Came to the performance of those elements themselves, so she had reasonably solid on technical execution. That slightly out of kilter finish and a nervous look up as well at the end of that routine, realising she was just away from the finish to that track. Coach Zhu alongside her watching on. And technical elements just out of the 40s, presentation solid as well. That 1 point deduction, 74-7. And don't think she's going to compete with Hock on that one, though she isn't. 121.24 is the final combined total for Li Jiangning. What was a 5.5 point advantage has been reduced to a 4 point deficit, so she slots into second position at the moment behind Annika Hock. Regina Medjesi in third, and Vincent Hagarova of Slovakia in fifth. After our first five skaters, and the next group now will come onto the ice. Patricia Gennaro of Italy, Maria Sotskova of Russia, Anastasia Galutsian of Armenia, and Yavropop of Finland. There's Annie. Is Lucrecia Gennaro. Some strong skaters in this next group, occupying the 11th position through into the top 10. And the likes of Sotskova and Galustian, both with 50 plus to their name. Galustian certainly has a chance here. Skater based in Moscow. She skates for Armenia. Foul, unfortunately, of the situation around the Sochi Games back in 2014, when the Russian coaches were no longer allowed to work with international skaters, or foreign national skaters were asked to work solely with Russian skaters in the build-up to the Olympic Games. So we had to search around for another coach. So it hasn't held her back too badly at all. Christian with two medals now on the ISU Challenger Series. Last of the group, Ivana Jiang of the USA. Energy athlete that puts that to really good use when you see the spinning elements to those jumps. And of course the spins on the ice. And capable of putting together an excellent routine. Finished in 10th position after the short program on 48-14. Just joined us. The next group of skaters out onto the ice. Ladies singles here in Lillehammer. The 2016 Winter Youth Olympic Games in free program, so the decider for the medals. And after this group, we will head into the third and final group, which contains the number one from the short program, Yuna Shirewa. Interestingly, Shirewa getting the clean ice and going off ahead of everyone else to set the standard. Very interesting final part to this contest, and from this group it's going to be interesting to see whether the key skaters, the two skaters that have got into the 50s with their scoring off the short program, are able to create a big enough score, not just to take the lead but also to set a benchmark for the rest. There is an opportunity for two athletes from this group to get a place on the podium, Maria Sotskova of Russia, Anastasia Galustyan, but it's a big ask.
Dana Young from the United States of America.
So last few moments of preparation, finer details being taken care of. So Yavupo of Finland.
Young.
And it's Lucrecia Gennaro will get things underway. 11th after the short program. There's a range of combination jumps in her routine. And we'll see the same from Sotskova. And as well from Galustyan, who starts with a really strong combination of jumps. No matter where you go, just give me some time, baby. Cause you know, even when we're apart, I know my heart is still there with you. 5 more hours till the night is ours, and I'll come back with you. This right here is my time for the countdown begins to our next group into the last 60 seconds of warm-up. I mentioned before we started our first group that we had some national champions on show. And Anna Jovanpa of Finland is exactly that, the new Finnish senior national champion from Tampere. She finished in silver medal position in the 2015 Nordic Games as well, and that's no mean feat. Ninth after the short program, but just out of the 50s. 8-7. Just joined us, a reminder that the lead at the moment is with Annika Hawk of Germany. 125-20 is the combined score, but we've got athletes in this group and the group to follow who are amongst the world's leading scorers in junior figure skating as things stand. Comes the current world record holder, Tuskaya of Russia. Goes in that final group, fourth after the short program, as the athletes make their way back to that enclosure just away from the ice. Italy's Lucrecia Gennaro, the only one left out there, ready to begin her free program.
Please welcome the next skater representing Italy, Lucrecia Gennaro.
So Lucrecia Gennaro in her first really big outing in international competition, just 14 years of age. Skated to Michael Bublé's Feeling Good in the short program. But it's a posthumous track called Minutis that she will open to here. That will then progress to a Vanessa May piece called Leyenda. May, of course, a winter sports athlete as well as a musician. Here we go with Gennaro's program. just 14 years of age, Lucrezia Gennaro with the longest step sequence that we've seen so far in the free program. But her real strength very definitely lays with the power in some of those jumps, and the opening group of jumps, that triple lutz followed by the triple loop, double toe loop, then into the triple loop and the triple salto double toe, really strong. An emotional moment, and you can understand why. That was a fabulous opening to that routine. The double axel to the single to the double, I'm afraid that triple just didn't quite work, but that really was the only downside to that routine. Maybe could have been that little bit more expressive through the linking manoeuvres, but had absolutely no problems with the jumps. Despite a little stumble through the latter combination, managed to stay upright. But this is the jumping at the start of the routine, really strong. Very, very confident on the combinations. The spins, solid. Followed by that extended step sequence, which linked the front and the back half of this routine together. That was the little mistake that nearly cost her the triple, but still managed to get some of those elements away. The combined leading mark of Annika Hock. Well, Gennaro got 47.45 in her short program. Hock got 41.52, so already a significant margin there for Gennaro. Lovely layback spin to finish. Should be happy all round. Into the 40s for technical elements and presentation. Maybe not quite where she wanted that to be. Combined score of those two going to 86.73. That does give her the lead. But it's a mark that certainly allows plenty of room for those to move past. A 134.18 for Lucrezia Gennaro of Italy as her combined score. Fabulous routine from her. So Maria Sotskova next out onto the ice for Russia. Good solid score of 53.40 in the short program. Has definitely given herself a chance here. And Sotskova will be skating to Sergei Prokofiev's track, Romeo and Juliet. Wonderful piece of music. Let's see if she can add to that. Thank you. Well, very, very strong choreography in that routine. The marvellously expressive 15-year-old Russian really enjoying the music, really enjoying that whole performance. And that will surely give her the chance of the lead. 134-18 at the moment with Lucrezia Gennaro of Italy. A couple of little errors in there coming out of two of the spins. Just didn't get it quite right. And one of the jumps as well. But did get some marvellous height, particularly on the opening jump to the sequences. Really did get a long way off the ice. But it was those linking elements, the choreography that was just so strong. Ivanova, who was the first coach to see this young lady skate when her mother brought her to the ice rink to see if she wanted to give it a go. And is now back and working with her. Piece of music. You still have to skate to it, you still have to bring it alive, and that's exactly what Maria Sotskova has done. Very, very strong elements. There's one of those huge jumps that she put in. Unfortunately, just on a couple of those combinations, wasn't able to control the height of the initial jump. For a few, but overall a really wonderful routine to watch. And responded as well immediately. It was the one error that was very obvious to see. Managed to stay upright and responded well. Genuine talent is Sotskova. It's a little ragged on that final spin. A little bit of fatigue setting in. But overall, excellent artistic delivery. Excellent choreography. And you've got a sense of real drama and real emotion as part of that routine. 86-73, the best score we've had on the free program so far. That was from Gennaro, and we are now comfortably into the hundreds. Maria Sotskova, 169.50, takes over in top spot by a long, long way. 35 marks the lead, and I think that's given her a real opportunity to maybe just climb a little higher than her eighth position. She'll be ruining that short program now. Maybe could have squeezed another few marks out of it. Well, they don't look too happy there, but they should be pleased with that free program. That was a good skate. Now another medal contender from, well, skating for Armenia, but actually based in Moscow. Anastasia Galustyan, 55.89 for seventh position. Up two medals on the ISU Challenger Series, so has proved that she's got what it takes on the big stage. Galustyan skating to a piece called Two Guitars. Thank you. No doubt about it. A wonderful skater to watch. But for whatever reason, a little problem on some of those edge jumps and pulled out of the triple loop in practice. I don't know if you noticed that while she was warming up just ahead of this group. But on a couple of occasions, pulled out of the triple and did it again in this routine. So there will be some frustration there for Galustyan. So much of that routine was so strong. It really was wonderful to watch. The spin elements, just superb. And once again, real emotion in terms of those linking sequences. It's clearly emotional as she comes away from the ice. I just wonder if there's a slight injury there. She's had a few problems, a meniscus injury on her knee that long ago. Maybe that's got something to do with the edge jumps, the fall as well, contributing to some issues. But other than that, it was strong. But again, plenty for the judges to be working with here. Positively, unfortunately as well, on a couple of occasions, negatively. And that may cost Galustyan. Sotskova of Russia leads on 169.50. That's the score to beat at the moment. Seem to get through the combinations relatively smoothly. A little later in that routine. It's an exquisite spin to finish. One to watch, held her spot very nicely indeed on the ice. Skaters made of pretty tough stuff. And, trying not to show too much as she came away from the ice, but I think maybe not quite at her best for this competition, physically that is, for the 16-year-old. Not good enough, I'm afraid. 77-3-2. Just couldn't quite deliver on the technical elements in the end. Real shame as well, because Galustyan is a great skater to watch. She's proved herself on the international stage, but 1:33.21 puts her down into third position behind Lucrecia Gennaro. So Gennaro is going to jump a space or two. Next skater onto the ice is Anni Järvinpää of Finland. Ninth after the short program. 48-27 her mark. And Anni, 16 years of age as well, will be skating to the Triangle Tango from Cirque du Soleil. Look out for some acrobatics during the course of this routine. Thank you. Well, so many qualities that you look for in a young figure skater, but having the heart to continue with that kind of vigour through to the end of a routine when you've had four falls already, that's certainly a quality that a lot of young sports people across the world could learn from. But it is, I'm afraid, disappointment for Anna Yavapa of Finland. And she will not improve on her short program situation. I just think it was the opening triple flip that really caught her out, and she just couldn't find her confidence after that. That's the problem. You're going to open with something that calms you down and settles you down for the routine. But if you miss that, then that's going to be a problem. Just think, falling on the opening triple flip, she had no double toe to follow. Affected her into the next triple, stumbled as she came out, just couldn't find the edge on landing. Pushed on, tried to create something with this routine, but the jumps just wouldn't happen. We've seen it before, it won't be the last time we see it, but going through a very tough time there watching Annie with those jumps. Great recovery though. Somehow still managed to commit to the choreography elements of this routine. Linking were really strong, but I'm afraid too much for the judges to look at there. Brief emotion as she left the arena. 72-64 leaves her on 129-1, which is going to be good enough at the moment to get her inside the top 10. Quite the top five, so sixth position just behind Li Jiangning, and Finland's new national champion. So disappointed here at the Youth Olympic Games in Lillehammer. So Maria Sotskova still leads with that fabulous score of 169.50. That is going to be a very, very strong mark for the final group. And in the meantime, let's see how Vana Jiang gets on for the USA. 16 years of age, skating her routine to the Island of Secrets soundtrack, composed by Panu Aaltio. Thank you. Wonderful finish. We'll let the judges deal with the jumps. There were a few elements in there that will receive deductions. But what a fabulous start to that routine. Really strong choreography. And when you have a piece of music like that, you have to skate to it. And no doubt about it, Vana Jiang of the USA has done exactly that. Really strong opening to the routine. Unfortunately for her, just couldn't quite deliver on a couple of the bigger jumps. You'll notice she keeps the skating boots very close together on a few of these landings. There were a couple of earlier edge landings that did look a little close. She paid the price, but the opening to this routine was just glorious. Right on cue with the music. It's the first of the falls. But again, didn't let it affect her. Pushed on beautifully through the routine. But is it enough to move her a position or two from her position at the end of the short program in 10th? She'd dearly love a top 10 finish here. 48-14, the initial mark. One athlete to go over the 100 mark on the free program so far, Sotskova. And a couple go over the 80 mark as well. Gennaro. Anika Hock. And there was that finish right on the music. 87-51. That is an excellent score from Vana Jiang. And I think she'll take that. 135-65 overall then her combined score. And that jumps just ahead of Lucrecia Gennaro. So she's top three at the moment. Well, you heard her say she's so disappointed with a smile on her face. Yes, there's a couple of those jumps she would have loved to have finished, but not quite. But it's good enough to put Vana Jiang of the USA into second position. Lucrecia Gennaro bumped down to third. That takes Anastasia Galustian out of the top three. But that fabulous free program score from Maria Sotskova. At the moment, unmatched. 116.10. For that combined score of 169.50 means that Maria Sotskova at the moment leads this competition with six skaters to come in the final group, including gold medal contenders from the short program. There's just something about that Sotskova routine. The expression of the choreographed elements, but she also produced some very big jumps as well. In modern parlance, they call it the complete package, and that's exactly what Sotskova showed us today in the free. We can gloss over some of those tumbles. So overall, that was a very, very confident piece of skating from the Russian. So 15-year-old Maria Sotskova leads. The action after that routine tells you all you need to know. She enjoyed it. So onto the ice comes the Zamboni. Come the technicians as well, just to take a look at those areas where some of the bigger jumps have happened and make sure that everything is nice and smooth for our final group. Chance for the volunteers and the mascot as well, Yob, to show us what they've got. Quite a lot by the looks of it. Great stuff. The next group come out to warm up, I'll bring you today with exactly what the situation is. But just a reminder, on clean ice, we'll have the lady that finished in first position at the end of the short program with a fabulous score of 60.87, the only athlete into the 60s. Gilewa of Japan comes in marginal favourite. Yori Sakamoto, her compatriot, will follow her. Fifth at the end of the short programme on 56.25, but with the score that Maria Sostakova has managed to put together at 169.50, then those athletes at 3.45, I think, are going to really feel it. Elizabeth Tursunbaeva of Kazakhstan, second after the short programme, she will skate 13. Fascinating to see what sort of mark Shirewa has set. Tursunbaeva's big name coach, Brian Orson, also of Canada. We see what his charge can do. See what Brian inspiring so many young athletes since his career came to a close. The latest of his charges. And following on 14 is Ji Byung-byun of Korea. Joined fifth position with Sakamoto on 56.25. And then another skater that is really in with a shot at the medals, Polina Truskaya of Russia, the ISU Junior Grand Prix champion, will be looking to deliver in the free program. And to finish things off, Diana Nikitina of Latvia, third place for her. Really good score in the short program, 58.81. Two-time Latvian junior champion, Rodriga, will finish things off. I think it's going to be, well, tremendous to see that head-to-head between Shirewa and Tursunbaeva. But also, we'll see what mark they've set for the medals when Truskaya and Nikina take to the ice. All of that still to come here live on YouTube. Fabulous entertainment so far on the rink today. This rink that holds so many wonderful memories over the years since its construction for the 94 games. And, just taking a look back to earlier today. Jimmy Broom was with you for the ice dance, and that was a gold medal for Russia. Shibovaya Shmernov taking gold, of Chloe Lewis and Logan By of the USA in silver, and then a second Russian pair on the podium, Skokova and Aleshin taking bronze medal. Russia performed very strongly Olympic competition over the two events, performing very strongly again today. That's the phrase. Each Youth Olympic Games has a phrase, incidentally. For Lillehammer, it is go beyond, create tomorrow. More than any other big international event that I've been involved with, the social media the younger athletes is incredible. It's been a pretty much a vital part of this Youth Olympic Games. Great way of getting updates home to your fans. Great way as well of finding out what the athletes are up to and what they've enjoyed about this experience here in Lillehammer. What an experience it is. And athletes here to compete in these games across a huge range of sports now, growing games on games. Scene is set then for what should be a very dramatic final session. And a few too many falls at the moment. Very disappointed athletes coming away from the ice. Let's hope that that isn't how this competition is decided. Let's hope it's decided on a routine as strong as Sotskova's routine, delivering that combined score of 169.50 for the lead. So we await number one ranked skater to take to the ice after the short program. This will come up very shortly once the Zamboni has done its work. Just joined us, ice preparation underway for the final group in this ladies singles figure skating. Short program was performed on Sunday. In the last group we have the first, second and third athletes who are in those medal positions at the moment. Shirewa of Japan leading the pack. We'll see the athletes out onto the ice to begin their warm-up. This ice preparation is finished. Underway with the last phase of this competition. But the next medals that we will see handed out at these games. Important though that we do stress it's not just about the medals here at the Youth Olympic Games. It is a wonderful experience overall. So many athletes talking about the fact that, okay, maybe they won't ever make an Olympics, but for them, this is their moment. This is their time to enjoy sport at this level. You often hear that from athletes who compete in the Universiade as well. This is their time to experience competition at this level. Don't forget, for a lot of athletes, that will mean that they are inspired to continue in the sport that they've chosen, maybe as coaches, maybe as administrators. Not just always about the top performers. We'll have to say, for this next half an hour, our focus will be on who can claim this ladies' singles figure skating gold. Potential for a really exciting finish to this competition. And part of that excitement has been already provided by Maria Sotskova of Russia, who has put in a marvellous free program score of 116.10. It could have been better than that as well. Just a couple of touchdowns during the course of some of her bigger jumps. Her combined score overall just below the 170 mark at 169.50. But the next group of skaters out onto the ice, no strangers to recording those kinds of scores, including the woman that holds the current junior world record combined score, Lina Tuskaya. She would have needed to have been just a little stronger in the short program. The Russian line in fourth at the moment after a score of 58.65 to really attack that world record again. Certainly a podium is an option.
The following skaters may now take the ice for a 6 minute warm up.
So 6 minutes of warm-up before we get this final group underway. Yuna Shirewa of Japan leading after the short program. Two-time ISU Junior Grand Prix gold medalist. There's a marvellous exhibition routine that she dances to the fantastically titled Defying Gravity from the musical Wicked. It won't be yet. Part of what she's doing this afternoon. It really is something to watch. And Shirewa will be joined by Kaori Sakamoto. She skates straight after her compatriot. Sakamoto in equal fifth position on 56.25. Then it'll be Elizabeth Tsimbaeva. Kazakhstan second, a score of 59.11. Coached by the legendary Canadian Olympic silver medalist, two-time silver medalist, Brian Olsa. Wonderful story, and she found that she was not going to be able to be coached by a Russian coach coming into Sochi 2014. Her mum wrote to Brian Olsa, sent the videos off and said, what do you think? Do you think you can make this skater a star? And Brian said yes, he'd love to work with her. And the rest is history. From Korea, skating 14, Ji Hyun Byun, that joint fifth position on 56.25 with Sakamoto. And that'll be Polina Tuskaya of Russia in fourth at the moment. More than capable of claiming a podium place. Although to do that, she's got to get past her compatriot Sotskova, who leads this competition at the moment on a fabulous score of 169.50. Yes, there's room to get past that, no doubt about it, but it's an excellent mark. And to finish things off from Latvia, Diana Nikitina, third at the moment with a score of 58.81 after that short program, the two-time Latvian junior champion. In impressive form here in Lillehammer.
She was born in Moscow and finished fourth at last year's Junior World Championship.
The stadium announcer as well, just giving us a rundown of the athletes out there on the ice. This is the moment to just get rid of a few of those last doubts, maybe just try and get through the elements to the jumps that you really need to nail. And in terms of jumps, what an incredible start to the first routine we're going to see. Yuna Shirewa opens with two triple triples. So a triple Lutz, followed by a triple toe loop. Both of those jumps using the pick on the end of the skate. And then she follows that with a triple Solko and a triple loop, which come from the edge jump category. So nice variation, showing us a little bit of absolutely everything at the start of her routine, and very, very important that she delivers on those two jumps if she's going to underline her challenge for the gold here in Lillehammer.
International competition she has entered this season. After the short program, she's in for Diana Nikitina from Latvia.
So into the last couple of minutes of this warm-up. It's so far been a wonderful competition. Sotskova of Russia leads ahead of Vana Jiang of the USA. A little bit out there on the ice did Jiang, but still delighted with her score of 87.51 for the free program. Sotskova, incidentally, the only athlete who scored over 100 for the free, 116.10, putting her in top spot. And the only other athlete into the 80s, Lucrezia Gennaro of Italy, 86.73, putting her in third position. So that's how it stands with our final six skaters, the top ranked skaters on the short program, and it'll be the leader, Yuna Shirewa, with the opportunity to lay down the first marker. The 1 minute countdown. Having a good look at this warm up, see if there's anything obvious that we can spot, but some confident jumping going on out there in this warm up phase. Sometimes pick up just a little issue or one of the skaters working in particular on one element. Very good shape. I think we're heading for a really good final session here. Tina still going through her final part of the warm-up. Looks like everyone else is good to go. The last person that will stay on the ice after that warm-up is our leader from the short program. Tremendously exciting skater to watch, Yuna Shirewa. An ISU best score of 186.80. That would surely be enough to give a gold today. But to get even close to that, she's going to have to nail the jumps, especially the two big triple triples at the start of this routine. Watch out for those first two combinations. A lot of pressure then on the 14-year-old. Starts off skating to Night Waltz. And then that wonderful Stephen Sondheim track, Send in the Clowns. You'll all hear that one when she changes her routine on the second phase. But it's the big jumps to open that we're looking at. The leader then with her routine going for gold. Thank you. real disappointment for Shirowa. That was a joy to watch, but not the strongest of finishes, and a fall as well.
From Japan.
In addition to that, you will have noticed not quite the strong start that she'd listed as her program components. And a little bit more safety first at the top end of that program. And Shirowa is going to have to wait and see what sort of mark she's set, but the body language will tell you all you need to know. As far as she's concerned, she might just have left the door open here. This is going to be a very nervy wait indeed for these marks. Well, the skaters will try not to give too much away under normal circumstances, but sometimes very difficult to hide your emotions. Well, that would have settled it, that opening combination. After that, it was single jumps, three in a row, into the layback spin. Just a feeling that maybe the step sequence was biding time through to the next jump. So maybe not as strong on the choreography as Sotskova. The fall just got tangled up. You could almost see that in the body language as she went into the final spin. You certainly saw it when the routine finished, collapsing away from that presentation to the judges, and we will see what sort of mark she gets and what sort of mark she manages to set for the rest of this field. Sotskova leads then on 169.50 with that fabulous free score of 116.10. It's not just about whether she can move into gold medal position, it's about the question that she asks of the rest of this field. Just watch the reaction when these marks come up. Here they come, 105.79. Oh, it's disappointment for Yuna Shirowa. 166.66 puts her into silver medal position at the moment. That bumps Vanna Jiang down to bronze. And Lucrezia Gennaro for Italy moves down to fourth place and off of the podium. It's a chance missed for Yuna Shirowa. Two-time ISU Junior Grand Prix gold medalist. In the last few months, left to ponder that routine here at the Youth Olympic Games. So not good news so far for Japan. Let's see if Kaori Sakamoto can maybe improve the mood. Fifth position, joint fifth position after the short program, and appropriately attired in purple. She will be skating to the colour purple, the theme, soundtrack theme from the film, written and produced by Quincy Jones. Well, it was good. But just like her compatriot, Yuna Shirewa, it was flawed.
From Japan,
and her reaction tells you exactly what she thinks about that. She's upset. And Kaori Sakamoto will have to wait and see what the judges make of this. Very strong opener. Some of the jumps at the top end, particularly the opening combinations, very good indeed. And then made her way confidently through the next triple, that triple flip to double toe, double toe. So trying to really express herself during the step sequence and the spins. But that missed triple loop may come back to haunt her. This was the opening combination, very strong. Just saw some confidence then coming out of that opening sequence. We started to find the feeling out there on the ice. Not sure she always looked completely at home with some of the spinning sequences. In comparison to the choreography of Sotskova, she knew she had to find something on the jumps and make those special. That routine, they were special. Provisional score wise, I think she's going to be around about the mark that Shirewa set. Scores to come then. Sotskova leads for Russia, Shirewa for Japan in second. Vana Jiang in that bronze medal position at the moment for the USA. That might be undone for Vana. This mark is confirmed. From her point of view, I can tell you the marks factoring system moving her up and down through the 50s at the moment. That 5.79 was Shirewa's final free program score. Just below that, it is 98.98 for 155.23. It's good enough for bronze medal at the moment, but some real talent to come, and Sakamoto knows that there is simply too much space, 30 points or so above her, into which the other challengers will be hoping to move. So the medal looking unlikely, and again, that thought's just hit her. So Japan precariously poised at the moment in silver and bronze. Russia strong in gold medal position with Sotskova, but some serious challenges to come, not least of all from Elizabeth Tershinbaeva. So the diminutive figure of Tershinbaeva, 16-year-old Kazakhstan skater, heads out onto the ice. Papa, can you hear me? The soundtrack that she will be dancing this program to.
The skies, I seem to see a million eyes. Which ones are yours?
Skating for Kazakhstan. And during phases of that program, skating quite beautifully. Not difficult to see why Brian Orser agreed to become involved with the coaching of this young lady. But like so many other athletes in this free program, unfortunately coming to grief on a couple of the jumps. And I'm not sure the Kazakhstan fans are going to be able to do enough here to convince the judges that that is going to set the mark worthy of gold. Has a shot at taking over from Soskova on 1.6950. I'd have to say, Tursunbayeva doesn't look too pleased about that. Very good opener. Had no problems at all with the triples. And really seemed to be enjoying herself out there on the ice. I thought maybe not quite as committed to the spins as she could have been. Just seemed to come out early on a couple of phases. As we moved on through the program, finally caught up with her on a tumble. We've already seen how costly that can be for Yuna Shirewa. Leader after the short program, now into silver medal position behind Soskova. Well, to get into the medals, 155.23, perfectly achievable for this young lady. She can get ahead of Soskova's 169.50 by how much is the question. Though under this kind of pressure, but 108.77, I'm afraid the Kazakhstan flags are not going to be waving too strongly after that. It's not gold medal position. Those 2 point deductions costing her in the end. 167.88 puts her into silver medal position, and that wonderful skate from Maria Sostkova keeps her in top spot. And well, I can't quite believe it, the Kazakhstan fans. Silver medal at the moment it is for Tursunbayeva. So Ji Hyun-byun of Korea, joint fifth position with Sakamoto. 2015 Volvo Cup bronze medal. So another athlete that has managed to deliver on the big stages. But this, a big routine for her, the 16-year-old, skating to the keyboard concerto in D minor by Julian Zilbakin. Thank you. second helping of Carmen this afternoon. Cheeky little sample in the middle of that piece of music. Thought she had recovered well from that initial fall. Unfortunately, that wasn't the case. And for Byun of Korea, what a heavy fall as well on one of those jumps. And that did knock the stuffing out of her for a moment, but managed to get through the routine. But the disappointment is very obvious. I think that will be now an impossible task for her to make it into the top three. So not quite as we expected things to go in this free program at the moment. Soskova not skating in the last group, moving from eighth position to first. So Soskova in that gold medal position. Rusumbayeva of Kazakhstan in silver medal, and our leader after the short program, marginal favorite coming into this final stage. Yuna Shirawa is in bronze medal position with two skaters still to come. Polina Toshkaya of Russia and Diana Nikitina of Latvia. So we can look back though at trials and tribulations of Yuna. It was the first fall, relatively tame one, but then pretty caught an edge as she came down. Jump. Took a very heavy tumble. A shame, because the opening to that routine was lovely. Just about saved herself on that occasion, but that was nasty. Doesn't it, to come out in front of the crowd and the world's media, television cameras, and perform. Really speculate as to how tough that must feel when things don't quite go your way. A few bumps and bruises after that routine. And for Byun, 87.45 for 143.70, probably what she would have been expecting. So that will put her just behind the 150s. Just after Sakamoto in fifth position, so not horrendous for Byun by any means, but it will set the mind wondering about what could have been, that's for certain. So the mark has been set, but not by the athlete we thought would set it. Maria Sotkova of Russia leads on 169.50. The next two athletes out onto the ice are capable of moving past that. Polina Suskaya then, for Russia, 58.65 after the short program, the ISU Junior Grand Prix champion and current record holder for the junior combined score. I said that today, I don't think, but certainly knows she's capable of going past 169.50. Dramatic costume, dramatic music, dramatic performance from Polina Shirskaya. She knew there was a chance there. And she has gone out and attempted to grab that with both hands. That's a superb routine. And she managed to land every single one of those jumps. Put the big combination in early doors. And once she hit that, that initial confidence that she was exuding when she came onto the ice just seemed to grow. And that has put Russia in with a chance of maybe even a 1-2 here today. Sotskova leads at the moment, but this is looking very good indeed for Sotskaya. And that surely has a chance of gold. The music, incidentally, elements of composition from the musical Chess by the male half of ABBA, Benny Andersson and Björn Ulvaeus. Couple of occasions when she landed the jump and she knew she nailed it, came out with real aplomb, but also a couple of occasions when she really hung on in there and fought for the jump to make it happen. And in the end, that was a very special, very strong routine, delivered wonderfully well here. Well, I said I hope that today was all about winning on performance rather than errors. At the moment, Sotskova and this young lady, Sotskaya, look like they're going to do exactly that. But which of them will be in gold medal position when the marks come out for this? I suspect it is going to be the lady in your picture. She doesn't look nervous at all, does she? Taking it all in her stride. Then looking for more medals from today's figure skating, and it's a great score. Wow, 127.39 gives a 186.04 overall. That is a fantastic total. That's right up there from Sotskaya, but more importantly than that, it's put her in gold medal position. And Russia are indeed 1-2. Sotskaya leads from Sotskova with just one more skater to come. Well, we were speculating this would be Japan's day, potentially. But it's been anything but. And Tursunbayeva of Kazakhstan in the bronze medal position means that Yura Shirewa, the leader after the short program, has been bumped down into fourth position with just this lady to potentially spoil the party. Third place then for the Latvian, Diana Nikitina, with a score of 58.81 after the short program. Two-time Latvian junior champion and our last skater in the ladies' singles free program. Three occasions of very quick thinking there from Nikitina. Meant that she landed those jumps and managed to keep the flow really going in that routine. Well, she's giving it absolutely everything out there. No real surprise to see the emotion coming through for the 15-year-old Latvian. Well, elements of the soundtrack from Jane Campion's 1993 Latvia. Film, yeah. The Piano, by the English composer Michael Nyman. That was the music of choice. The Russian fans wonder whether that is going to be good enough, but surely Tskaya on 186.04 has put herself out of sight here. An outside opportunity for Diana Nikitina for a place on the podium, but it's going to be a big ask. To do that, she has to beat Tursunbaeva's score of 167.88. She's going to be close. She's certainly going to be close. Lads, those were tears of joy in the end, because there was a couple of jumps in there that could have gone the other way, but wonderful, quick thinking, great footwork, got herself into position to complete the combinations. Really strong skater, there's one of those elements that she still managed to link together. A couple of occasions, certainly during the early part of that routine, looked a little breathless, and I just wonder whether the nerves had got to Nikitina. Wonderful recovery, and she got to the step sequence after the last of the jumps and really started to enjoy her work from there. You saw a smile appear on the face, the crowd were on side. A very strong finish in the end from her, but will it be enough for a medal? I think it's going to be mighty close. Tursunbaeva, a member of Kazakhstan, in that bronze medal position, scored 108.77 on the free program for 167.88. She's a mark down on her. Great finish, great response. Is it going to be the score that she's looking for? Is it going to be a place on the podium? No, it isn't. Oh, it's disappointment in terms of a medal, but it's a fantastic skate from Diana Nikitina. That's a good result on the big stage. 165.60 drops her into fifth position, just behind Shirova. Gold and silver going to Russia. Bronze going to Kazakhstan. All three of those athletes based training in Moscow. So we know each other very well indeed. Nice words of wisdom from the coach. So close for Nikitina, but not quite. Confirmation then of that wonderful score. Polina Tskaya has done it again with a magnificent total. 186.04 to take gold medal here at this Winter Youth Olympic Games in the women's singles figure skating. Maria Sotskova of Russia makes it a 1-2 for the Russians with silver. And then just down on that, Tursunbaeva, a little disappointed after her routine, but will come away with a medal. And unfortunately for Yuna Shirova, the marginal favourite after winning the short programme coming into this event, just not able to find it with her free program routine, and Shirova confined to fourth position. As the athletes will always tell you, that's the cruelest position of all, just off the podium. Well, a really good competition, really enjoyable to watch. A lot of athletes delivering on personal goals, and when it actually came to the medals, Tskaya and Sotskova really did the business. Routines almost free of error, seeing some very good scores to take the medals. So a bronze and a gold in the ice dance for Russia, and now a silver and a gold in the women's singles. Here come the crew, down goes the red carpet. And if you stay with us, I hope we will be able to bring you pictures here on YouTube of the medal ceremony. That's all to come. So stay with us. Yeah, let's.
Mesdames et messieurs, la cérémonie des vainqueurs du patinage artistique individuel femmes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the ladies' figure skating.
Mine damer og herrer, velkommen til medaljeseremoni for kunstløp kvinner.
And then to get our medal ceremonies underway. Hopefully we will have time to bring you both the ladies' singles and the ice dance presentations. A fantastic afternoon of competition here. Party.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Sami Mudalal, Syrian Arab Republic, member of the International Olympic Committee, accompanied by Mr. Stefan Yombier, Olympian, one silver medal, representing the International Skating Union.
Olympic silver medal, Stefan Yombier. Athletes commenting on social media here at this and the previous Youth Olympic Games that it's a chance to meet some of their heroes and heroines from winter sport. They have certainly turned out to support the senior athletes, have turned out to support the juniors.
Bronze medalist representing Kazakhstan.
Winner of bronze medal from Kazakhstan,
So Elizabeth Tursunbayeva, so close, but in the end, just a little disappointed with her routine. And one too many errors to really mount a challenge for gold, but 167.88, good enough to hold off the challenge of Japan's number one, Yuna Shirewa, to finish in that bronze medal position. So Kazakhstan. Tursunbayeva taking bronze. Congratulations from Stefan Lombia. Scott.
Médaille d'argent représentant la Fédération russe.
Silver medalist representing the Russian Federation.
Winner of silver medal from Russia, Maria Sotskova.
Third medal of the day on the ice for Russia. It's been a good day for them. Maria Sotskova. Out to take the applause of the crowd before being presented with her Winter Youth Olympic Games silver medal. Excellent to see. Just congratulating bronze medalist Tursunbayeva.
Olympic
champion representing the I love it. The ice floor manager there just holding Paulina back. She was desperate to get out there and take the applause from this crowd here in Lillehammer. Fabulous performance from the 14-year-old Russian. And Paulina Sudskaya delivering into the 180s once again with her combined score. I'll say a quick congratulations to the other two medalists, including her compatriot, Maria Sotskova. A fourth medal in the day for Russia, and it's a special one. Gold in the ladies' singles figure skating. Congratulations to our medalists from the ladies' competition this afternoon. Genuinely brilliant skate in that free program from Sudskaya to claim the medal. And now the Russian national anthem. State anthem of the Russian Federation heralds a second gold medal for that country on the ice this afternoon here in Lillehammer. A superb skate from both Sudskaya and Sotskova to make it a 1-2 on that podium for Russia, with Kazakhstan taking a very well-earned medal through Elizabeta Sambayeva. Sorts of twists and turns during the course of the afternoon's free program skating. Sotskova really putting the cat amongst the pigeons with that brilliant effort in group two. But in the end, Sudskaya managing to be in a class of her own. Three more names from the Winter Youth Olympic Games to keep an eye on over future years. Stars most definitely in the making. Little lap of honour now for our medalists, as has become the tradition. A few social media photo opportunities, I'm sure, with the fans. That's right, get in the right position there. Paulina, well done. Three athletes that live and train in very close proximity in Moscow, so each other very well, as you can see by the discussions going on between all three medalists. More photos. Enjoy the moment. I'm sure it won't be the last time that we see them celebrating the big championships on the podium. Marina Tsarskaya then gold for Russia. Maria Sotskova silver for Russian Federation. And Elizabeth Tursunbayeva bronze medal for Kazakhstan. Leave the arena. Congratulations to all three. A little look back on what the three athletes did. Just a couple of errors in that Tursunbayeva routine. Just couldn't quite live with the pace set by this woman. A wonderful, expressive, dramatic routine from Maria Sotskova. Set the standard that the others struggled to cope with. Until that is another dramatic routine from Polina Tsarskaya. Really came out and made the ice her own today. The judges had no problem whatsoever going with her for gold. So from the ladies' singles, hopefully we're going to move to the ice dance medal from this afternoon. Another fantastic competition. Charlie Broom was with you for that one here on YouTube. That one went down to the wire as well, a dramatic finish, and the favourites for gold couldn't quite deliver it in the end. Russia claiming the first gold of the day on the ice. Now with the ladies' singles, they've made it two. It's been a very, very good day in Lillehammer for the Russian Federation. Learning to change the flag around from the gold medal position. But USA getting in between the two Russian Federation pairs to claim silver. So that is a change. Presentation party for the Winter Youth Olympic Games ice dance comes out on to the red carpet. Stefan doing another turn as part of the presentation committee and joined by Mr. Wu of Chinese Taipei on the IOC Executive Committee. Skopkova and Aleshin just couldn't quite finish the job today. But we'll come away from this Winter Youth Olympic Games with a thoroughly deserved bronze medal. One of four medals today for the Russian Federation on the ice. The honours with regard regard to the first of our medals in the ice dance. Bronze medal then. A dramatic competition. Stefan Longo once again steps in with the Lynx mascot, Jog, designed in a massive competition held across Norway over the course of the last 9 months or so before the final design was accepted. Only Kazakhstan and the USA have managed to get in amongst the medals today. Such as the strength been of the Russian Federation skaters, Chloe Lewis and Logan By. Very good job in the ice dance to claim that silver medal. Now making the most of their celebration, moments that you do not want to forget. Always good to see the athletes adhering to protocol, going across to congratulate their opponents that they will meet time and time again at Grand Prix events, and then maybe on to the senior tour, and maybe in future world championships and Olympic Games. We certainly hope so. Congratulations to the US pair as we prepare to welcome the gold medalists from the ice dance.
Gold medalists and Youth Olympic Games champions representing the Russian Federation.
Vinnere av gullmedaljen og ungdomsolympiske mestere fra Russland, Anastasia Smirnova, Grigor Smirnov.
It sounds pretty good, doesn't it? Youth Olympic Games champions and a gold medal to take away from Lillehammer to Sava. Fantastic performance from Anastasia Shibaleva and Grigory Smirnov. So again, a chance to congratulate and I'm sure commiserate with their compatriots. Just missed out today in that bronze medal position. Federation not far off from making it a 1-2-1-2. Love to see that. Love to see the athletes checking out their medals on the podium. Doing it at the Olympic Games as well. Can't resist a little look once the medal has been presented. This is the medal they all wanted, the gold, presented by Mr. Wu, IOC Executive Committee member from Chinese Taipei. It's gold to Shipaleva and Chmianov. Second time today here on the ice, the Russian Federation national anthem. Our medalists from the ice dance competition here at this Youth Olympic Games in Lillehammer. Shibulova and Shmyanov take gold. Chloe Lewis and Logan Bai of the USA just managing to get in between the two Russian pairs. And, they take that silver medal. Bronze going to Skopkova and Eleshin. And now an opportunity to just go and say hi to the fans in the crowd, but also last few press photographs. I'm sure you'll see those on the Youth Olympic Games website. Just a little reminder there that we are watching athletes that are still very much at the start of their career and not always familiar with the protocol surrounding these various post-event presentations. But you can see by the reaction of all the athletes, the smiles on the faces, as far as they're concerned, that doesn't matter. They're just happy to be part of the podium here at Lillehammer 2016. More just with the gold medalists this time. So again, keep an eye on the names for the future. I'm sure we'll see many of the athletes featuring here in Lillehammer during the course of this week and the years to come. At last, someone has managed to get a Russian Federation flag out to the ice for the photo opportunity. That's better. Not to be outdone. Chloe and Logan just heading across to the US fans and saying, have we got a flag? But in the end they've borrowed the one from the organisers, from the flags that have been hoisted into the air while the national anthems were playing. That's a nice touch. So the US pair, the last of the photographs as the Russian pairs parade around and enjoy. It's been a very good day for the team and for them. Well, that concludes our presentation ceremonies. And that concludes our day of live coverage here on YouTube from the ice rink. Some fabulous competition in the ice dance and in the ladies singles. Confirmation that bronze medal going to Skopkova and Eleshin. The silver medal going to Chloe Lewis and Logan Bai of the USA. But gold for the second time today. Shibulova and Shmyanov claiming top spot on the podium, to go with Polina Tsarskaya of Russia claiming that gold medal in the singles. Fabulous stuff. That's it for our live coverage today from this 2016 Winter Youth Olympic Games in Lillehammer. Thank you very much for your company during the course of the day. Tomorrow we will have live biathlon for you, the exciting singles mixed event. But for now, from the figure skating, it's goodbye. And from all of us here at the Youth Olympic Games YouTube team, thank you for watching and we'll see you again tomorrow.